Friends, we are in the module number 4 of water technology, and in this session we are going to discuss about the determination of COD and BOD. Okay, this is very important in a theory as well as in practicals. We are discussing the same in theory also. Very simple question of the same definitions will be asked for 4 marks, and the viva part will be asked in a laboratory exam. Okay, so let us understand what is this COD, chemical oxygen demand, and biological oxygen demand. Okay, which is one of the important parameter to know the amount of oxygen required for oxidizing the impurities present in a wastewater samples. You know, in the case of the closed drains and all, it will be imparting a very bad odor. Why it is? Because water will be, or water can dissolve some amount of oxygen in it. Okay, when there is lack of oxygen, what will happen, you know, the impurities which are present in water uses the dissolved oxygen of water. The dissolved oxygen is also used from water. There is no more oxygen available. So what happens? The impurities are remaining like that only, without any decomposition. So they will be imparting large amount of the bad waters in the drains or in a drain water, lakes, etc. Fine. So what is this chemical oxygen demand, or COD? It's a amount of the oxygen required for a complete chemical oxidation of a organic and inorganic impurities present in a wastewater sample. And here we are using a strong chemical oxidizing agent like a acidified potassium dichromate. COD is the amount of oxygen required for the complete chemical oxidation of organic and inorganic impurities present in a wastewater sample by using a strong chemical oxidizing agent like potassium dichromate. And what is BOD? BOD, you know, it is carried out by microorganisms, and it will take around 5 days of time at 20 degrees centigrade. So it's the amount of oxygen required by microorganisms to oxidize the only the organic impurities. See, in the case of the COD, it is both organic and inorganic impurities. No, in biological oxygen demand, it's only the organic impurities present in the wastewater sample, okay, which is kept at a 20 degree centigrade for 5 days of time. Okay, BOD is oxidation of only the organic impurities, because it is oxidized here by using the microorganisms. They will take some time, right? Immediately it cannot be done. So we need to keep all the required conditions for 5 days. In the first case, chemical oxygen demand, we are using the chemical reagent, chemical oxidizing agent, so that the reaction can be carried out fastly, right? Okay, so it can be done immediately where and when required. Okay, so if a question is asked like, which is the fastest parameter, the answer is COD is the fastest parameter, and as BOD requires 5 days of time. Okay, which is the highest parameter means it's only a logical answer. Okay, it is a COD, because it contains the oxidation of both the organic and inorganic impurities. Biological oxidation means it's only the oxidation of organic impurities. So BOD is slightly lesser and COD is always slightly higher, we can say. Fine. So this is about the definitions of COD, BOD, and always the COD is a faster and higher parameter. BOD is a, it will take time, 5 days of time, and it is a lesser parameter. Okay, how to do this experiment in a laboratory? Okay, here, no, the principle of this method is, here we are going to measure the amount of the unreacted potassium dichromate. We are adding a 25 ml known quantity of the potassium dichromate, but we don't know how much exactly the potassium dichromate required. So here we will be conducting a blank titration. Blank titration is the one where we are not taking the sample solution. Okay, so in that way we can measure the unreacted potassium dichromate, and from that we can calculate the amount of the oxygen required for oxidizing the impurities present in the wastewater sample. So for which, what we have to do, we need to prepare a standard potassium, standard ferrous ammonium sulfate solution. Standard ferrous ammonium sulfate solution is to be prepared. For that we need to weigh the FAS and transfer into volumetric flask. Add 2 test tubes of dilute sulfuric acid. Make up the solution accurately up to the mark. Okay, this is about the preparation of the standard solution of FAS. Weigh the salt, add 2 test tubes of sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid, make up the solution accurately up to the mark and mix well. Okay, and for a back titration, the procedure is pipette out 25 ml of the given wastewater sample, and also pipette out 25 ml of the potassium dichromate. Add 2 test tubes of sulfuric acid containing silver sulfate and mercuric sulfate. Here silver sulfate is used as a catalyst for oxidizing some of the organic compounds and pyridine. Okay, and mercuric sulfate is added to bind the halides present in water. Generally in water samples, frequently the chloride ions will be present. Okay, that will also be interfering the titration. Okay, so to avoid the interference of the chloride ions, we are adding here mercuric sulfate. When we add mercuric sulfate, the mercuric sulfate will be reacting with the chloride to form mercuric chloride. Okay, in that way we are binding the chloride ions so that it will not interfere in the reaction. Okay, and then add 5 to 6 drops of the ferrine indicator. You will be getting a blue-green color. Okay, titrate against a standard FAH solution taken in the burette until you get a reddish brown color. I think it's clear. Okay, we have to take 25 ml of the FAH solution, and also we have to take 25 ml of the potassium dichromate solution. Add 2 test tubes of H2SO4 containing silver sulfate and mercuric sulfate. Silver sulfate is a catalyst. Mercuric sulfate is added to bind the chloride ions, and add some 5 to 6 drops of ferrine indicator. And the ferrine indicator, its chemical composition is ferrous 1,10 phenanthrolein sulfate. Okay, you will be getting a blue green color. Titrate the solution against standard FAH taken in the burette to get a reddish brown color. That is the end point. Okay, and then blank titration has to be performed to know the amount of the unreacted potassium dichromate. So for that, what we have to do, just don't take the sample, which is the sample here, wastewater. Don't take wastewater sample. Remaining all the other reagents we need to take. What are all the other reagents? Pipette out as usual 25 ml of the dichromate. Add 2 test tubes of H2SO4 containing silver and mercuric sulfate, and add a ferrine indicator and titrate against FAH taken in the burette. Okay, so you will be getting a V1 and V2, right? Fine. For the first titration, blank titration, note down the burette reading, and for back titration also note down the burette reading. Okay, from the difference we can calculate the amount of the oxygen required to oxidize the impurities present in water by doing this calculation. Fine. Which calculation we have to do? It is the formula is here. Okay, which is N into, N is the normality of the FAH solution, B minus A, or you can write X minus Y, whatever it is. B is the volume of the FAH is consumed for blank titration, and A is the volume of FAH is consumed for back titration, that is normal titration, into 8000 by 25 milligrams of oxygen per dm cube. Okay, N is the normality of FAH solution, B is the volume of FAH consumed for blank titration, A is the volume of FAH consumed for back titration, okay, by 25 ml of the solution taken. Fine. So you can calculate the amount of the oxygen required for oxidizing the organic and inorganic impurities present in the wastewater sample in milligrams of oxygen per dm cube. And this now the problems will be asked like this. Make use of the following data in a pseudo analysis. In a effluent sample consumed 35 ml and 19.5 ml. The higher volume 35 ml is the Y, okay, and 19.5 ml is the X, okay, like B minus A. Blank titration minus back titration value is given, and a concentration of the FAH solution is given, 0.05 normal. Okay, calculate the COD of the effluent sample. Write the formula. 8000 into Y minus X into Z by B. Okay, 8000 is written, 35 minus 19.5 into normality of the FAH is 0.05 and volume taken is 25. You will be getting the dash milligrams, that is 248 milligrams of oxygen per dm cube. Okay, one more sum in a similar way, where the 28.1 and 14 ml of the FAH were consumed in a COD test. Okay, so what will happen? It will come to around 225.6 milligrams of oxygen per dm cube. I think it's clear now. COD is the amount of oxygen required for oxidizing both organic and inorganic impurities. VOD is the amount of oxygen required by microorganisms for oxidizing only the organic impurities. COD can be done immediately. BOD will take 5 days of time, and COD is the fastest parameter and highest parameter. Fine. And these are few examples for problems that will be asked in your exams. Okay, we will be meeting with a new topic in the next coming sessions. Until then, thank you.